darkness to light, from death to immortality. Om, peace, peace, peace.
Mirabai, a 16th century Hindu mystic saint, poet, devotee of Sri Krishna. Thousands of poems and devotional songs are composed by Mira, dedicating her ecstatic divine love for Krishna. O mind, let us go to the shore of Ganga and Yamuna river. The pure stainless water of these rivers makes your bodies cool and sanctified pure. Krishna is playing flute and singing with his brother Vasudeva at the river shore of river Ganga and Yamuna. Devotee Mira wants to put her head on the lotus feet of Sri Krishna, who held up the Mount Govardhan, also known as Giridharanagar.
Chalo mana Ganga Jamuna Tir, chalo mana Ganga Jamuna Tir, chalo mana Ganga Jamuna Tir, Ganga Jamuna Nirmal Pani, Ganga Jamuna Nirmal Pani, Shitala Bhuta Sharir, chalo mana Ganga Jamuna Tir.
Jamuna Nirmala Pani, Ganga Jamuna Nirmala Pani. I'm reading from the book Eternal Words, Spiritual Instructions of Swami Adbhutananda by Swami Siddhananda. Here Swami Adbhutananda says, one who loves God is blessed. Because there is selfishness in human love, a person may love someone today but hate him tomorrow. But there is no trace of selfishness in God's love. If you treat a person well 99 times but offend him just once, he will hate you. If you commit 99 offenses towards God but call upon him with restless longing only once, he will give you shelter. It is very bad to have outer devotion and inner deceitfulness. God is very far away from that. These people perform devotion either with one or another selfish motive. For this reason, they do not grow spiritually. That is why the master used to say that one must unite the mind and the speech in the practice of devotion. No benefit comes from a show of devotion. Such acts are product of a calculating mind. God is surely far off from that. Devotion done for display cannot last long. Its true nature is revealed with time. For that reason, whatever you do, do it with proper love and respect. Whoever does so is surely a true devotee. I will read one incident from his life, which shows his love for Holy Mother. In 1907, Holy Mother came to Calcutta from Jayarambati to attend Durga Puja at Girish Ghosh house, and she stayed at Balaram's house for a month. Latu, that is Swami Adbhutananda, lived in a room to the right of the main entrance. While entering the house, the mother saw her dear Latu. She inquired, "Hello, my son Latu, how are you?" Latu replied in his unpolished rustic language, "Go away, mother. You are a dignified lady. Why have you come to the outer apartment to speak to me? Please go upstairs right away. I will not speak to you here. You could have sent for me and I would have come up to see you. Mother, I am your servant, you know." Laughing, Holy Mother went upstairs to her room. As long as Holy Mother stayed at Balaram Basu's house, she sent prasad to Latu every day. Other devotees would go to see Holy Mother, but Latu stayed in his room. Some devotees misunderstood him because he did not go to pay his respects to the mother. One day he told them, "Look, is it so easy to understand the mother? Just imagine, she accepted the master's worship." Only the master knew the real nature of the mother. And Swamiji understood a little. She is Mother Lakshmi herself. It needs a lot of austerity to understand her grace. The day arrived when Holy Mother was leaving for Jayarambati. All the devotees went to bow down to the mother upstairs. But again, Latu did not go. He was pacing in his room and muttering to himself, "Who is a mother or father to a monk? He is free from all Maya." When the mother was coming down the steps, she overheard what Latu was saying. When she reached his door, she said, "Dear Latu, you will not have to accept me, my son." Immediately, Latu sprang from his room and fell at mother's feet and began to sob like a little child. Seeing her child, Latu cry, tears came to mother's eyes. Latu took the corner of his chadar and began to wipe the mother's tears. He said to her with a choked voice, "Mother, you are going to our father's house. You should not cry. Sharat will bring you back soon. Don't cry, mother, don't. Is it proper for one to cry when one departs?" Yes, sir. Thank you.
Good morning, friends. Today's title of this discussion is Madly in Love. In the beautiful book on love of God, ascribed to Narada, whom Sri Ramakrishna describes as the great lover of God, by whose association even this devotion is transmitted to others. So Narada wrote an aphorism about devotion. What is real love? Called Narada Bhakti Sutra. Aphorisms on the devotion to God. And how did he define devotion, love of God? He said, love is supreme love on God. That's called bhakti. Sa tasmin parama prema rupa. It has to be supreme devotion. That's what our subject today is, madly in love of God, of course. What is love, you know? Love begets liking. We love country, we love flowers, we love season, we love sunrise. This is a common love. We love some people, we love someone, and we love the way they talk. We feel their company very nice. But what is madly to be loving some in madly situation? So that type of love is when we cannot live without that being or situation or ideas. And when that love is directed towards God, that becomes real devotion. Parabhakti, supreme love, parama prema. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is supposed to be incarnation of love. It is said in the Chaitanya literature that Sri Krishna saw gopis loving him tremendously, mad in love of Krishna, and enjoying the love. That Krishna thought, but I love all, but what is that madly love in me? Like gopis love for God, love for me. I want to enjoy that love. Now Krishna also wants to enjoy the bhakti of the devotees. Then he incarnated as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Krishna, but having the love of gopis in his heart. And he says, how can that love grow? That love, madness of love can grow. He said, Trinadapi sunichena tarorapi saishmana amanina manadena kirtaniya sadahari. Four qualities first to develop that supreme love for God. Feel yourself humble. Give up arrogance. Do not be egotistic. Eschew pride. Be equal with all. Be like a grass. So humble. People tremble. People walk on grass, but it doesn't complain. No complaint. Trinadapi sunichena. And be like a tree. For what? To endure. What winds fall, but tree remains at its place. Tarorapi saishmana. Endure the problem, challenges, difficulties of life. That is way to bhakti. Two qualities. Amanina manadena. Don't expect any honor from anyone. No honor. No respect from anyone. Be humble like a grass. No expectation from anyone. Manadena, but respect all. Treat all as respectable persons. All are children of God. You are going to love God. You have a desire to love God tremendously, supremely love God. Then you have to respect all, because all are children of God. All are creation of Krishna. How to develop that love for human being, that love for God? He says at the last quarter, Kirtaniya Sadahari. Always remember the name of God. Always sing the glory of God. Always repeat the holy name of God. That will make you humble like the grass, firmer like a tree, and not expecting anything from others, giving honor and respect to all, and you will attain that blessedness of supreme devotion. See, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, when the time of eagerness to have God's love, that supreme love come, when will that arise in me? How will that be seen? That when will I have, Chaitanya says, Nayanam galadasru dharaya, vadanam gadgadarudhaya gira, ulakai nijitam vapu kadat tavanama grahane pavishyati. Oh Lord, when that day will come, when I repeat your name, when my eyes will shed tears like the rainy season, not stop, I will cry for you. Nothing else I want. I want you. You are my focus. Because I am not getting you, nothing seems to be adorable. Nayanam gargastru dharaya, vadanam gargada ruddhaya gira. And throat is choked with emotion. Pulakai nijitam vapukada. And holy place in the body. Yes, standing in the body. When will that happen? When I repeat your name, I want that state fully absorbed in you, man in thy love. That Chaitanya says. And when that has happened, after devotion that has come, then sometimes God reveals and sometimes he disappears. That is the play with God and devotee. Hide and seek. So that devotion grows more. And he said, God is not being seen. I cannot meditate on God firmly. I can get the form of God in my memory during my meditation. I feel so bad. What type of badness when you feel dissociated, detached, gone away, separated from God? Chaitanya describes that. Yuga itam nimeshena. Moment of your separation from you seems like the age is eons. Moment looks like eons. That because I am separated from you. Chakshusha praprishaitam. And I cry for you like the rainy season. Sunyaitam jagat sarvam. There is everything in the world. But this world has become empty for me, sunya for me, zero for me. Because Govinda virahename. Without seeing you, I want you, I am mad in love for you, O Lord, O Govinda, O Krishna, but I am not getting you. So nothing matters in this world, nothing can comfort me. I want you and you alone. Sri Ramakrishna used to love one song very much. Amai Dema Pagal Kore. O Mother, make me mad with thy love. And this is referred in the Gospel 9 times, various places. And when it was sung, Sri Ramakrishna said, this is my ideal, loving God madly, being mad in God's love. O Mother, make me mad with thy love. What need have I of knowledge or reason? Make me drunk with thy love's wine. O thou who stillest thy devotee's heart, drown me deep in the sea of thy love. Here in this world, this madhouse of thine, some laugh, some weep, some dance for joy. Jesus, Buddha, Majus, Gauranga, all are drunk with the wine of thy love. O Mother, when shall I be blessed by joining their blissful company? When I become closer in my attitude and feeling toward this great devotee of God. What Sri Ramakrishna loved to call, be mad in love of God, give up everything. This is being mad in love. Sri Ramakrishna became that mad himself. He wanted to see God in the image that he was supposed to worship. He started worshipping and then felt that if God is not there, why to worship this stone image? That still Mother was not revealing. Then he was started rubbing his mouth on the ground, "Mother, mother," bleeding all the way, nose bruised, face bruised, mad in love. Still mother not showing. What a play of devotee and God. One day he went there, mad in love. What is worth this life if God is not there? Took the sword that was hanging in the temple and said, "I will finish my life because I have not realized God. Worthless life without God." And was going to do that, fell down. And saw the ocean of Satchidananda, that light, coming in waves and drowned him. And he became, we call unconscious, but he was in super conscious state. He had enlightenment. As Buddha had under the Bodh tree in Gaya, Sri Ramakrishna had in the temple of Mother Kali in Dakshineswar near Calcutta. Realization of the ultimate truth. Mother revealed, God seeing, with the madness of love, that is the purpose of madness of love. God comes, reveals. That madness did not leave Sri Ramakrishna. One after another, he wants to know how Vaishnavas worship God, how Muslims worship God, how Christians worship God, how Advaita is practiced. One after another, madness to understand the various paths that lead to God. Never seen that madness to realize God in the history of bhakta devotion. One way you found God, that's fine. You are full. Sri Ramakrishna was not full. He was not satisfied by realizing God in one path. I want to know how Muslims pray, how Christians pray in the church, how is Jesus, who is Jesus? And he practiced Islam and Christianity and Vaishnava Tantra and Advaita, and it was revealed, God revealed to him. That was sheer madness of a person who had already realized God, wants to reach God through various ways. He wants to taste the cake not only through one way, it tastes this way, right? What about this way I eat? That also seems sweet. What about the other side? It is same sweet. Cake is sweet from on all sides. The path to God is sweet on all sides, and you reach the same place, he said. Did after realizing God through various paths and through various faith, did his madness stop? No. His madness was throughout his life. One drunkard comes to him, he was sitting at dead of night, at midnight. The mad Sri Ramakrishna used to be called a mad Brahmin. People used to call him. He was really mad, mad of love. First God, now human beings. Came and he, drunkard, comes with the alcohol smelling from mouth. He is a saintly person who cannot touch any impure person. Now this, he welcomes him at midnight, holds his hand and starts dancing. And he is not satisfied with being mad by himself. He wants to make everyone mad. Mad with love of God. That is Sri Ramakrishna. He went to Panihati, saw there was festivity going on, let us go and do something, happy occasion. As soon as the carriage went to Panihati, he jumped from that and mixed in the crowd and started dancing. People had said, "Don't dance, you may aggravate your illness." Who will stop this mad person? Started dancing the whole day, like Yam had described beautifully how he was dancing like a lion, like a mad elephant. He started dancing with the group and the singing and with the music of cymbal and the drums. And it went on all day. He used to eat very little, frail, not a strong person. But who will stop this person from this madness of love of God? We heard the Mirabai story. The songs are beautiful. It says, let us go to the bank of Ganga and Yamuna. What is that bank? We're reaching, our hearts will be cooled. We'll be at peace. Let us go there. That is God, for her that is Krishna, for the Ramakrishna devotee that is Ramakrishna, Holy Mother. Come to them, you will be cool, you will be peaceful. That is the bank of Ganga and Yamuna. Ramakrishna one side, Holy Mother other side, and love of Ganga flowing. Come to them, you feel the cool breeze, you feel peace, all our anxieties, worries, which we call sins, are gone, purified by their presence. And what happened to Mirabai herself? She was a queen. Love of Krishna grew so much in her heart, her palace was given up. You have seen people giving up palaces and crown for the sake of love of human being. England happened. But here was a different love. It is love of God. It is eternal, it is permanent, it's fulfilling. It is never separating. She started going to the monks, to the commoner, started singing the songs of Krishna. From queen she became beggar for the love of God, mad in love of God, and sings, Mato Prema Divani. I have become really mad with love of God. She feels that. And people, people from the palace was now, queen has gone, mixing with the commoner and singing the song, dancing in the street. They said, this should not be the case. We will be, people will say what the king and the queen had become. They want to kill that queen, Mirabai, and said, poison. Mirabai drinks that, nothing happens. When God says, what will happen? That is getting mad in love of God. Narayan comes, says, he comes to the bank of Ganga and Yamuna, to Sri Ramakrishna himself, searching for God, love of God. If God is there, everyone says, scriptures say, mother prays every day, but where is that God? I have not seen. Is there anyone who has seen God? Nobody could be found. He traveled many, went to many spiritual leaders, all saying directly. Nobody said that I have seen God. He wanted proof if there is God. Have you seen God? If you say, God is there, of course. Who will deny? We believe in God. But have you seen God? Nobody could say. Some say, eyes are like a yogi's eyes, Narayan. That won't satisfy him. Sri Ramakrishna was asked, sir, have you seen God? Sri Ramakrishna said, yes, my child. And I can make you see God. Himself mad. He wants to make the whole world mad. Now a young man has come. Now he wants him to see God and be mad with the love of God. And that was Sri Ramakrishna's love. Narayan fell in poverty. No money to buy even food. The eldest son of the family. With job, he was not getting any job that time. He was B.A., then Bachelor of Arts at that time, one of the highest education. Everyone, even lower studied people will get the job. Narayan was not getting job. And then, how was Sri Ramakrishna love? He was talking to another devotee and said, Narayan is not getting job. Can you find some job for him? He felt embarrassed. Why are you talking about my problem to this person, this devotee? He has come to talk to you about God. He has not come here to solve my problems. He protests. But this mad person, whose love for Narayan now has directed his madness, has directed from God to man. Narayan is one representative. And said, Narayan, for you I can go to beg door to door. What to ask about this unknown person for help? I can go and beg for you to every door. That was his madness of love for Narayan. Was it for Narayan? It was for all of us. When Narayan said, I want to be mad in love of God and want to be with God alone, nothing with the world. I want to be in Samadhi, always. He says, fire upon you. I thought you have a big receptacle. I thought you would become like a huge banyan tree and you are talking like this. It doesn't fit you. You have to give shelter to many people. You have to give spirituality to many people. You have to remove the sufferings of the people at large. And now you are saying you want yourself to enjoy the bliss of God? Mad for God alone? No. Now he is with me. When I have seen that you have finished mother's work, then your door will be open to reach God. Naren was pushed into the work, hard work, unknown place. Who did that? Sri Ramakrishna. When he was in Madras, he was thinking, whether should I go or not? People are saying, go and attend the parliament of religions. Sri Ramakrishna on the sea, he was talking and saying, come. He could hear the vision. Come, come. Where to go? Who will take care? Nobody I know, nothing is there. No, come. You have to work for the people. You have to embrace the humanity. You are born for that, not for yourself alone. That is madness for everyone. Saw people suffering. He could read the mind. Took head out from the carriage when he was returning to the sinister. Went to Holy Mother and said, oh, I saw these people of Calcutta. I like the worms crawling in the dark. All their mind in worries, filled with worry, how to eat, what to do, how to enjoy. That alone thought. There's a greater joy of God. Nothing about that. How this possibility of realizing God, having that great joy, is all cut short and only thinking of how to live, totally body-centered. And suffering, bound slave of senses, something to be done, mad for the human beings, for others, said to Holy Mother, you will have to do for the people. I am sick, my body will not last. And Holy Mother said, what I will do? Sri Ramakrishna was there, Holy Mother was such a great herself, divine being, and she worked so miracle. In her 32 or 34 years after Sri Ramakrishna's passing away, her life. How did Naren love? She was also mad in love. Disciple of Sri Ramakrishna, another mad person. One bull was coming, hitting a lady. They were not connected in Pinky Meadows in England. And all men, everyone fled away to save themselves. Naren, lover of mankind, came forward, facing the bull, protecting that lady. And what happened? That bull came and just didn't charge him. He just stopped before hitting him. People all applauded Swamiji for his great bravery and courage to save a woman. And they said, Swamiji, what were you thinking when bull was charging towards you? This heart might be praying, he might be having some mantra that bull stop. He said, no, I was thinking how far this bull will hit me and how far I will be thrown behind. I was only thinking that. Who saved him? That was his madness of love. Sri Ramakrishna was sick, cancer, wound. He couldn't eat. Whatever he ate came out from the throat. Big wound. And once he was eating, and this gruel, and it all came out from the throat and fell on a bowl which was taken. Some porries, liquid porries, mixed with pus and blood, kept there. They had heard of cancer, they had thought it was very infectious. So people who were serving him were afraid now. Their parents said, don't go, it infects us. Now Naren found in the band of young people who were taking care of Sri Ramakrishna, a fear has come that it might be infectious. Mad in love as he was, Sri Ramakrishna, Naren was. He went and took that bowl of that gruel and put it and drank the whole thing. Is it not madness of love for Sri Ramakrishna? That's what is called madness of love. One devotee comes to Nag Mahasaya. He saw Sri Ramakrishna ailing. First he said, you are a yogi, you can cure yourself, you have that power to heal. Sri Ramakrishna said, what are you saying? You are such a great devotee. And you are advising me to keep, put that mind which is given to the divine on this cage of flesh and blood and bone, on this body, to cure it? No, that is not the way. I will not do that. Then that devotee said, then I will take all your sickness, illness. I will become sick, you will be cured. And that devotee was doing something. Sri Ramakrishna pushed him back. No, you can't do that. Isn't it madness of love? That Nag Mahasaya, what a great householder devotee. Once he was in his place, Deobhog, in Bangladesh, that time it was East Bengal, of India. Rainy season, one person came in the winter time. It was raining, he was all dressed to meet him, he had come. Now, there was no fire. All the wood that was kept was all got wet by the rain. Now, he wanted to light some fire. He was shivering with cold, drenched in rain. Now, where to find dry wood? This Nag Mahasaya went outside, broke his poles, and whatever it was supporting, that wood he brought out by breaking his own house, poles of his house. And that he burned, fire was lit, and said, now you dry yourself, you make yourself warm. What a madness of love for another devotee. That was not Mahasaya. Mad in love of God and God's creation. Gopis love, you know, how the gopis loved Sri Krishna, God. It is described in the Bhagavata that whenever they heard flute of Krishna, all gopis ran away from house. Whatever they were doing, they just came because Krishna's flute, his music has come, his attraction has come. Always thinking of Krishna all the time. Krishna was not a boy, he was God. And gopis were not ladies or girls, they were devotees. When Mirabai came to Vrindavan, there was one of the disciples of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. She wanted to see him. And that was Swami. He said, no, I don't see any woman. She was a practicing monastic like person, Goswami. Mirabai sent message, oh, in Vrindavan I thought there is only one man. Only one man. That is Krishna, and all are women. All are devotees, there is no man and woman. If you consider devotees a woman, all are gopis in Vrindavan. All seek, are longing for Krishna. Only Krishna is Purushottama, all are bhaktas. So where this came, another man came who doesn't want to see another woman. This message, when he went to Goswamiji, he came out and begged. He was a great scholar and bhakta also. That was gopi and Sri Krishna's relationship, devotee and God, nothing else. And when Sri Krishna came, flute was playing, he was playing flute. This is described in the Bhagavata how mad they were in love for Krishna. That whatever they were doing, they just ran. Some were breastfeeding their children. They put the child down and ran. One was cooking something. She even didn't put the pot from the oven. Ran. It will burn, whatever, I don't know. Some was sweeping the house. She ran. Just left that broomstick there. That was Krishna's love, and that was the madness of gopis for God. That's God madly in love. God first. Everything else next. That is the priority. How much did Holy Mother love? Holy Mother's love for devotees. When a young monk came to meet Holy Mother, Swami Girijananda, a fever and he had to go back. One cart was there, a bullock cart. And when he left, Kulimandra came out to see her off, came along the cart to a pond called Punnipukur. And the Girijanandi writes, till I was visible, the cart was visible, Holy Mother didn't go back. She was standing there and looking at her son going away. It was perhaps the first visit of Swami Girijanandi there. That was her love. That is the real magic love. When you separate pains, like Bhagavatamandi's love for Holy Mother, you see, that was magic love. When separation is there, it's very painful. And when it's simple love, okay, you come, it's fine, I like you, your presence is also okay. But when you're mad in love, it is very difficult going. You come and see, you see off and see the train going. You still can't give that person away. Train is passing, and you see on the back, oh, train is ever visible. The last body, last car of the train is visible. You go on there, after that I will come. That is the real true love. One lady comes to Holy Mother, poor lady from the village. Holy Mother said, you seem sick, stay in my room. You're that bad. That was really sick, lady was sick. Then she vomited, dirtied the bed, linen was dirty. Holy Mother didn't say anything. And she didn't say to any other household. After that, she became a little better, the lady. That was sent with some food. And she kept that linen herself and washed herself. She had many household people, inclusive would have said, was that? Because why did she have to do that? She was not a young lady that time. Because she was mad in love with the devotees, with her children, nothing else. She will have to do herself, clean the things. One day it was seen at night, some devotee came. And he saw some one person has come, there is one kerosene lamp on the road, it is seen at night. Nobody should be there, all villagers should have slept. So what is, one person was doing something on the road, it was not metal road. Came close and saw Holy Mother. Said, what are you doing at this hour? Oh, there's some glasses I saw in the evening, and some glasses were scattered, broken glasses. And if people are walking, some do have shoes, some many do not have, and it may hurt them, it may prick them. So just I was cleaning that. Why she has to clean? She could have told to anyone. But what to do? She was mad in love with the devotees. She has to serve by herself. And there is so much joy in this madness. Ramakrishna's love for Sri Ramakrishna. You know how mad he was in love with Sri Ramakrishna? Narendranath, the group leader, he was there. He was the leader of the monastic brotherhood. And no food was there. There was one banana gift for Sri Ramakrishna to be offered in the temple. And Naren said, there is nothing and one banana is there for ever hungry and you gift for that old person? I will go and eat that. He went inside. Ramakrishnananda went inside, pushed Swami Vivekananda out. That he was mad with love with Sri Ramakrishna. But Sri Ramakrishna was not the picture there. It was a living presence. He could do anything for the sake of Sri Ramakrishna. Even punishing his own leader. Who gave him sannyasa, who gave him name, who gave him the name that Swami Vivekananda loved most. Ramakrishnananda was the name that Swami Vivekananda himself would have liked to give that name. Because Ramakrishna was his most lovable being. He knew that. But he saw service of Sri Ramakrishna by Ramakrishnananda. I have to sacrifice this name for him. He deserves more perhaps. And one night, it was rain. It was dilapidated house. The rain was coming in the room. Sri Ramaswami Ramakrishnananda went with an umbrella in the shrine and opened the umbrella and held it all night until it rained. because few drops may fall on the photograph of Sri Ramakrishna. Sri Ramakrishna photograph or no photograph. Divine Mother Kali's image was no image for Sri Ramakrishna. It was Divine Mother herself. He will feed Holy Mother, Divine Mother, Mother Kali there and see the Mother Kali eating. For Ramakrishna Nanda, it was not photograph of Sri Ramakrishna. It was Sri Ramakrishna himself. If a drop of water falls on him, he will get wet. So I have to sacrifice my sleep. There was nothing in Madras. Came new place, doesn't know language, doesn't know food, no devotee. Who knows Sri Ramakrishna there? Few devotees that Swami Vivekananda had introduced. And then there was nothing to offer, nothing to eat. One day he was very upset with Sri Ramakrishna and said, there is nothing you are providing. I will go and collect the sand from the bank, from the beach, of the ocean, and offer that to you. What to do? You are not providing anything. What power I have? And not only I have offered that to you, then I will eat that as your prasad. This is all madness, examples of madness of love. And you would have done. You would have done surely that. But Sri Ramakrishna was watching all this and was making an example of how one disciple should love his guru, how a devotee should love God. That was the example he was setting. And in the afternoon, a devotee came with a lot of articles, rice, and fruits, and all the things. Saint Francis of Assisi, he went to church, not very devoted to Jesus, just went to the church as customary on Sunday. Suddenly he hears the voice, my church is breaking. You have to repair it. Now, Jesus came, he could hear the voice, feel the presence, whole life changed from a very frivolous person to a saint. Love for Jesus began and increased. How much it increased? And he started seeing Jesus in everything. Meditation on Jesus became so deep that he himself got stigmata, the wound signs, scars of wound on his hands and on his feet. That much was his devotion for Jesus. And he started seeing Jesus, his Lord, in everything, in birds and animals, in every human being. Nothing was lagged behind and nothing was accepted as not having love of God. He started feeding birds, taking care of the wild animals. That's how this madness of love can go, from God to man, from creator to creation, and from the creator God to the creation children. That's how the love flows. When that madness catches, then everyone becomes a form of God. This is the real bhakti, parabhakti, when it's called parabhakti. Narada says about this devotion, how it is that the supreme love, it is gunarahitam, kamanarahitam, pratikshana vardhamanam, avichinnam, sukshmataram, anubhavarupam. If the prema, the supreme love, the madly love, is without attributes, without any desire, and goes on increasing every moment, it is an unbroken inner experience, subtler than the subtlest. It is not bound by three gunas of rajas, tamas, and sattva. Sattva gives us joy, happiness by getting something. Rajas makes us active, tamas makes us inert, sleepy, drowsy. But this love transcends all these. The joy is found within, not on something, some object. And he is not passionate, active only, not bound by anything. And that devotee is not in inertia or lazy. It has no desire, free from desire. Supreme love will make you free from the worldly desire. Only desire is to see God in everyone, in every heart. Pratikshana vardhamanam. It go on increasing. It will engulf yourself. It is like a fire that will engulf your heart. That is the sign of true love. And it is very subtle. When that love is obtained, after attainment of that love, the devotee sees only that. hears about that alone, speaks of that alone, thinks of that only, that is God. He thinks of God, he hears of God, he talks of God, only God alone. Sri Ramakrishna is the best example. And here also it says, when he talks, kantha varodha romancha subhi parasparam lapamana pavayanti kulani prithivincha. When such devotee happens, who has become mad in love with God, and meets another devotee, then he starts talking about God. When he talks about God, his most beloved being, then his throat gets choked, and then hairs stand on end, tears flow. And when such devotee is immersed in this world, as transformed in this world, then pavayanti kulani, the whole generation, his whole family, lineage becomes purified. And not only family, whole world gets purified and gets someone who can take them away. When such devotees are there, they are the ones who make the holy pilgrimage, Tirthi Kurvanti Tirthani. Pilgrimage is made by the devotees. Today we go to see Assisi in Italy. Why we go? Just because St. Francis was born and worked there, lived there. These pilgrimages are made by these great devotees. When you go to Benares, no doubt it's a city of Shiva. But if you remember, here Shankaracharya came, Ramanuja came, Sri Ramakrishna came, Holy Mother came, Swami Vivekananda came, and you feel so much their presence, it becomes holier. Just by Shiva, it's fine, it's holy, definitely it's great. But when you find association of all these holy persons there, then you see condensed holiness there in Vishwanatha, in Varanasi. Tirthi Kuran, they not only do Tirtha, they make places of pilgrimage, but also Shastri Kurvanti Shastrani. They validate the scriptures. The scriptures describe this. They practice, they become the real example of scriptures. Unless there were devotees like that, the scripture will be dry. There are things, it will become theory. Have you seen God? Question comes, that's why. And you find someone has seen God. Unless you find someone has seen God, then how will we? Faith in God will be deposited in us. So these devotees who are mad in love of God, they validate the scriptures. The scriptures get its verity by their presence. So when such devotees, mad with love for God, are there, they become like one devotee becomes big center of attraction, big place where problems will be solved. When something happens in their home, people call me, Swamiji, this happened. Why holy man or some monk connection with Sri Ramakrishna? That comes. They think of Sri Ramakrishna and kind of talk with Sri Ramakrishna. Someone needs to be talk with the person, so they call me. But real connection with this Sri Ramakrishna. That's why we all become, you must have failed, some problem comes, then they will call you. You see, I failed this happened to me. They want to talk, they want to find peace that is within you. And that becomes, the more we become mad in love of God, that is our focus becomes only God, abhyavicharini bhakti, that is pure love without any adulteration. Unadulterated love for God. When this love becomes adulterated, if you love God and also you love gold, also you love land, also some name and fame, that becomes adulterated love. Because you are not one pointed, one focused. The unadulterated love, if that is there, one pointed, focused love for God, we all become mind of strength, source of inspiration. Through life, our life just becomes successful. This, and we find peace and joy in life. So let our mind flow towards God. And as our mind starts flowing towards God, another big stream comes from them and we get connected very quickly. Our power may not be able to take there, but His power comes and connects and become one with God. May He bless us all. we have true love for Him, and our love for Him, our devotion for Him, may turn into the supreme love for God. Thank you.